So what I want to tell you about today is now something I think a little bit more high level than what you have seen before, and that's really a great starting point for Marco and as well for Roger, basically talking about the technical aspects about actually going about to certify something. So basically what I'm telling you about is a process that we started within the ETSI QKD industry specification group. And it's something where we at the start of something, so therefore I will not tell you anything about results. I just want to tell you a little bit about the path that we intend to take, and let's see where we're going from there. And the starting point of that one is, of course, the stuff that you heard from Marco, right? So if you think about quantum key distribution, then there are some parts basically which are simple, and that is basically to do security proofs, right? You do a model, you have a protocol, you run through the whole thing, and then basically you end up with a scientific security proof, which is basically math, right? You just have to do math to do that stuff, right? And the thing is, of course, now the moment you go out there and you have an actual device sitting on the table, right? Then now you have a problem, of course, that all these models that you assumed in your security proof, that's not really something which applies to the device that's on your table, right? And I mean, Heukong Loh, but as well Vadim Markov are really famous for actually pointing out the difference between what's on the table and what the model is, right? Because that's the definition of a model, right? It's not the thing itself. There's always a gap between the device and the model, right? And so basically, there we basically are at the end of the security proofs, right? You have as well more about software, hardware implementation, right? And the thing is basically, while the security proofs, of course, sitting there with the scientific standards over here, basically the testing procedures is something which you really basically have to do basically best practice. And when we talk about certification and standards for certification, then this is just the best practice, something where people sit together in a room and say, what could happen? Where do we think basically, what do we think needs to be tested? Basically, what are the big open gaps? And basically, as well, where stop? And that's something like what Roger said at the end. The question is, when do you stop with your refined modeling for something, right? So when can you actually stop with all of those things, right? And so basically, that is basically, in a way, the task that actually we have in front of us. And of course, it's basically possible to change this kind of to reduce the model assumption in QKD, and of course, basically, we can go all the way up to device-independent QKD, or halfway, basically, reduce stuff with measurement device-independent QKD and all of that one, but you never get completely rid of that problem. Whatever you're doing, there's always a boundary that needs to be checked, right? And as well, I mean, for us, it's a QKD community, it's always very important for us to be clear about what is the message, why is it that we are interested in QKD, right? I mean, it's not... So the important thing in a way is not that QKD, I can do mathematical security proofs. No, provable security is not the point, because you still have to implement the protocol. So basically, for us, really, the message about why QKD would be always that basically the key that we create with QKD is secure for all future as it's the time of creation, right? Which does not say the key is secure, right? But it's still something that you cannot achieve with other methods. But that's all basically the kind of background that we're having, right? And so that can be reformulated. But now the question is, now once we say, okay, we need now to go about and do certification procedures, right? That's basically what we want to have. That's what the customer wants to have, somewhere as a stamp of approval to say, this device that you're buying is secure, right? It's doing, and now we have to think about what does it really mean? We cannot really say, oh, the key that you create is secure. It only says basically, it basically satisfies what we said is the best practice approach, right? About that people ensured that we didn't do stupid stuff and that it basically fits into the whole picture, right? And the thing is basically, all of that, of course, needs to be made formal. And then now you need basically a framework. How you actually can achieve something like that one, how can I formally go through a process where I can, in the end of the day, say a certain device that you buy from a vendor basically is basically approved, is certified. Right? So the process for that one in ETSI, basically we are thinking at the moment really to go along the line, something which is called common criteria. And I heard about this common criteria many years ago when I was still working in the CQC project over here in Europe, right? And I mean, there are many people of sitting here, and Thomas Lange at that point told us something about common criteria, and me as a poor physicist, I was sitting there and say, what the heck is this actually doing? Because common criteria certification say, is basically only to say, oh, the device is doing whatever the guys building it, certifying it, said it is doing, right? Which is a kind of convoluted thing. So, but maybe we should basically be a little bit more precise what it actually means. So common criteria is a framework, and basically for certifying device, and basically it's the most important documents actually that need to be written for that one. The first important one is actually the so-called protection profile. The protection profile, and then the second one is called security target. Strange name, basically. What the thing is, basically, the protection profile is basically written by a community where you basically say what is it that you expect a particular device to deliver. So when we say basically, that's basically something that we are doing over here, we are already sitting there basically say, okay, point-to-point QKD device, what do we expect that thing to do? Right? And so we can talk about apps, I think, like apps on security. Right, going security proof bars, but as well, we say basically what against what kind of side channels, what type of attack scenarios do we want to have it protected against? Right, so that's basically, with other words, this protection profile is a kind of a wish list, what you think actually the device actually should satisfy. Right, and then very roughly speaking, the security target is now another document written by the manufacturer. And what the manufacturer is just saying, basically, for all points that in this wish list of the protection profile, basically, is listed over there, basically, in security target, you just say how and why you think that your device satisfies that one. Right? So basically, that is now from the device manufacturer saying, okay, this is how I address the points, basically, the task list that the protection profile gave to me. You work through that and say how each of those points is actually addressed. Right? So there's another document, target of evaluation, that basically says what is actually your device. So we can ignore that for the moment, right? And so once you have those documents, that's at the moment just a piece of paper, right? Basically, once you have these documents, then you can actually go to the certification process, because now you actually certification labs go about and they basically take these kind of two documents and check your device, basically the device actually against the security target and against the protection profile, whether all of that is actually properly addressed, yes or no. And then basically, then they write a report. That report is basically given to the manufacturer. The manufacturer actually goes with that report to the kind of local certification authorities in the different countries and just basically gets the whole thing approved. Right? Those certification authorities as well come into the game in way that they endorse something like a protection profile. If we are lucky, they do that, right? And then say basically, this is a protection profile that might make sense. They might give it a recommendation that indeed people using those devices look for devices that are certified against this protection profile, right? And now, if you look at all those things, I mean, I said basically, as a wider community, we contribute to the protection profile. But when I mean here a wider community, we really talk about scientists, but I think even more, and that's really the important part, about industry. Yeah, telecom providers who might want to deploy QKD would actually come in and actually say as well, what do we want, right? So they basically think about, well, I want to deploy QKD. But then basically in order to buy device of it, what do we really require those QKD devices to do, right? So that's basically come in. Basically now the role here of people, most people here at the conference, basically now who come in there from the science angle, basically what we are doing is basically to have something like auxiliary documents that are actually referred to in this protection profile. Right? And basically what there's, basically there's a lot of technical detail, for example, how to protect yourself against particular side channels. Right? What are measurements that you're doing? It's something Marcus mentioned, the Trojan horse attacks, right? So basically we can prepare, the document really says basically how you address the threat of Trojan horse attacks. The protection profile would, for example, say QKD devices should be secure against Trojan horse attacks. Right? And then basically, what are possible methods? Oh, well, there are some documents over here. Right? And that is basically our main job as a community to come actually into that part. And so basically, this is the process that we are envisioning at the moment. And basically, what we're doing at the moment is basically to make sure that we have all the right people on board. Right? When you run through a process like that one, as I said, we need quite a big community in there. And so basically, here's a kind of complete list, basically what type of people we need. We need technical experts. We always start somehow with that first. And basically, in the Etsy QKD IG, we have lots of those, and basically more are coming in. That's basically really to have this expertise that we can do this best practice decisions, right? So we have people like Vadim Makarov in there as well. We have more theory people in there, just to say what are possible attacks, what is it we need to guard ourselves against that one. Then the next thing is, of course, you need to have QKD device manufacturers in there. So we have already some of them in the group. More, of course, always welcome to join. And then comes the next layer as well, because QKD is envisioned not to be just a standalone part, but basically its use, it needs to be connected to somewhere in the network. So typically, you will have as well companies in there that actually work on network technology, basically all kind of routers work on those kind of things. They're interested in interfaces, but as well in specification what those devices should be doing, that they're connecting to. And that is as well something we are looking very much for as well more people on that level. And then we need as well actually something like the service providers and managing customers that actually, who would actually deploy those devices on their networks. Again, they have some idea about what they want, especially if they're going into the service provider model and want to offer a service for other people. Right? Then they need to be sure, basically, what assurance do they give that the QKD devices that they are buying to put them into their networks actually doing the jobs that they basically say they are selling to their customers, right? The next part is, well, basically we said you write documents over here, but at some point the certification process itself is taking part in testing labs. So you want to have them on board to really make sure whatever you're writing in there actually makes sense and can actually be implemented in actual testing routines for someone that they can check off the boxes. And then, of course, you need as well the kind of national certification bodies that basically gives the overall stamp approval to something like a protection profile, and as well, basically, as of course, they play a role as well in the certification process itself. So this is basically the whole set of people that we need in all of that one. So you see, basically, this is a long-term process. This is not happening overnight, right? But the thing is, basically, that's the process at the moment, be it getting all those people on the table, at the table, so that we can actually start and move the process. And as said, basically, the outcome of it will be documents, right? That really say, basically, that is basically what devices should be, in the end of the day, be tested against. And I think, basically, that's probably already all that I should say right now, because we all know we want to go for dinner at some point, and I think we wanted to have some question session before as well. Okay, thank you very much for your attention.